This is my 2007 335i. I just picked this up last Thursday from Brooklyn, New York, and I paid $3,250, making it the cheapest 335i in the USA. Okay, let's take a look. So this car is a 2007 335i. This has the N54 engine with twin turbochargers, direct injection, and a 6-speed automatic transmission. This is the sedan version of the E90, and I picked this up in New York. I found it on eBay for $3,750. I offered the seller $3,250, which they accepted. Now on the inside, this car looks like brand new, pretty much. Big shout out to the seller, Eugene, for taking such good care of this car over the years. It truly is like a new car. Now this car has the fold down rear seats, the through loading system option, and the ski pass. This opens up here somewhere, that little button. There's our ski bag. This is how you know you have a modern BMW, is when there's actually cup holders that work in the back. Now, as you can see from the front seats and the steering wheel and paddle shifters, this is a sport package car. It has the premium package, leather, winter package with the heated seats, heated side mirrors, and a couple other things go into that as well. Now, as for the wheels, these cars came with 17-inch wheels. However, 18s were an option, and these are the 18-inch staggered option that the owner selected when he ordered this car. There's 255s in the back and 225s in the front. Now I want you guys to guess in the comments below, based on the condition that you've seen, how many miles do you think are on this car, based on the price and the condition? Or maybe it's more fun to just guess based on the condition. We have the paddle shifters here. Very cool. Never had anything like this before. We have the start-stop button here. This has the modern key where you place the key into the dashboard and press the start-stop button. Very cool. Also has the paddle shifters, which is an option. And then down here you can see the heated seats and the stereo. This does not have the GPS. This is an early March 2007 car. So there's no navigation unit with the menu screen. And I actually prefer it that way. Some of the older screens get dated as the car ages. However, if you don't have one, it sort of remains timeless in a way. This car also has the standard cup holders here in the dashboard. Typical E90 design, which is pretty cool. These ones are not broken, so I can't complain about them yet. Now in the center console here, we have another cup holder, an aux input cable, and it looks like a power outlet here. Then we have a little lucky dollar tied up here in the front. And there's one in the back here too. If anybody knows what that's about or what that means, let me know in the comments below. And this car is all original paint. Has a clean Carfax. Never been in an accident, according to the owner and Carfax. Trunk looks like new as well, as do all of the seals. It smells like a brand new car. And we got a little bottle of oil here and a little storage compartment. What's also interesting is there's no toolkit here against the trunk lid, like all of the earlier generations of cars. And let's look under the hood. Here is the N54 twin turbo motor. And the only modification this car has is this split second turbo tuner, which increases the boost very modestly. And that was installed for basically since the car was new without any issue, according to the original owner.